the night, I hear him talk the cold story.
Yo, 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 what is up, everybody? It's your main man, Wing Drops. And I'm here. It's here. With super official magic box unboxing. Can you dig, baby? No, I can. Hey, listen, man. So, I ordered a Magic the Gathering deck builder's toolkit online on Amazon. It's because some of my friends are getting interested in playing Magic. We're more of Vanguard players, as you can see by the mat here. But yeah, some of them are interested in getting into Magic, and I thought, you know, a fun way to show them how to play, or mainly the only way I know how to play actually, is by doing drafts. Apparently online they're called cube drafts. I did not notice before, but I used to do drafts with my roommates back at Berkeley. Shout out to Estebanio. Shout out to all my roommates, you know who you are. Nuo, Anvars. I haven't said these names in so long. Gustavo. Along with special guests, who else played with us? I think it was Ethan and Victor and Andy Lowe? I forget. But anyway, we did these drafts with this exact deck builder's kit. Not the exact one, the one I ordered here is going to be the 2020 version. Hopefully, if it isn't actually that inside the box, then oops, awkward. I guess I'll just trash this video. But yeah, the one we used back at Berkeley was Steven's box. It was the I forget exactly what it was called, but it was the one with the Joker, what's it called, looking guy on it. He looks kind of like Shaco from League of Legends. I'll have the picture of it on the screen here somewhere. But we had that one, that deck builder's cool kit. And yeah, we would just take the cards from there and draft it. It's pretty good if you have like four-ish people, 4 to 5 maybe. It's enough cards for that, because it comes with a good amount of lands, but it's not the most extensive, I guess, collection you can get. But yeah, I'm gonna just open it up and see what's inside. Let's get into it. Let's open this up. Just be a barbarian and tear through it. Okay. These kid scissors aren't doing me any favors. Did I get it? Okay. See, I don't really care about this box, because it's just the package, right? Shout out to Corky. Alright. Pour it open, see what's inside. There's the box. Here's some fancy dancy bubble wrap, perfectly placed so that it's contained. Now let's remove the box from the package. There you go. This is the Deck Builder's Toolkit featuring, I'm not sure who that is. I don't really play Magic. Is that Lena? I forget her name. The girl from Dota? Actually, no. Dota and Magic aren't related, right? It would be Warcraft and Magic. No, Warcraft and Hearthstone. What's Magic related to? D&D. So I don't know who this is. Alright, let's see what else is on here. You got the Wizards.com. You know, copyright information. There's a nice little lion here. Serial code. This side of the box has nothing. Here we got another look at this character charging up a falcon punch. This side of the box, nothing. And the bottom, you kind of saw when I opened the package. Expand your collection instantly. The Deck Builder's Toolkit puts 285 cards at your disposal with everything you need to create multiple Magic decks. So yeah, 285 cards is a lot. When we did drafts with my roommates, we would usually do maybe 40 card decks ish 30 to 40 card decks when we do a draft together. And if you multiply that by 4, that's about 160 cards. So you can easily, this can accommodate. So it comes with 4 15 card booster packs from recent sets. Looks like there's one guaranteed one and three mystery ones.
What does that say? That is the Core Set 2020 Booster Pack.
Right here, this one. 100 basic land cards, essential. Though maybe not. Depends on your situation. Back at the Parker House, these were essential. When we play at Legends, most likely, at Eastridge, they have a land like set over there. So you can literally just borrow as whatever lands you want from the store and use it as long as you don't take them, I guess. But as long as you stay in the back gaming room, you can use those lands. So if you're at Legends, not as essential, but if you're playing at home, you need these basic land cards. Comes with the Deck Builder's Guide. 125 cards from recent sets. That's basically what you're going to be drafting with. And a reusable card storage box. Made in the USA, MagicTheGathering.com, Wizards of the Coast. All right, let's get this open. Give a little snip at the end here. Get this plastic layer of plastic off. Jeez. Okay. Okay. There's the box. And let's pop the top. It's not one of those boxes. Is it like... what? How do I open this? It's a slider. That's right. It's the same format. It's the same, not format. Same structure, I guess, as Steven's box from Parker House. There you have it. There's the nice storage box, I guess. Magic the Gathering on the top. Some kind of symbol. Oh, cool. And there's something else that was in here that didn't slide out with the rest. That's the Deck Builder's Guide. I'm not gonna go through this too much. It just shows you the... oh, I remember Steven had one of these too. Just shows you the basics of the game. What the colors do and stuff. Building around Synergy. Manicure. This is supposed to be important, but whenever I played, I kind of disregarded it. You should, of course, try to build on the curve, but when I'm drafting, I just like to go for whatever. Yeah, quick reference, expand your collection. Simple guide. Alright, now let's find a card. So, to open this, I think it's one of those boxes where you pull out like this. It's like one of these kind of boxes, I don't know what you call these. And there you have it. Contents. So there's this big thing in the middle. This is... I'm gonna take this out later. This is just to hold it in place real pretty like right now. But obviously... wait. Hold on. Because in theory, all the cards right now would be able to fit just how they are, right? So you can leave this in and separate your cards into two stacks, I guess. But yeah, I don't know what I was talking about. At first I thought in my head, I was like, wait, I need to remove this so when I open all the cards, they can all fit in the box. But the cards are all fitting in the box right now, so I don't know why I was thinking that. Let's start from the left to the right. We'll do the packs last, actually. So we'll do left here, and then these, and then the packs. So, the first... looks like these are a part of the 125 cards that come with the set. Because as you can see, it's not a basic land card. This is one of those dual land cards that it's good for mixed decks. You can use it either as a red or a white, but it enters tapped, so you can't use it right away. That's the weakness. So let's get this open. I'm so bad. Gonna have to use the scissors off camera. Okay. So I'm not gonna go through all these cards one by one. I'll just flash them briefly for you guys. You can pause the video if you want to look at any individual cards. Wind, Discard, Crag. more of that. Jungle Hollow. It's one of those lands. Jungle Hollow. Swift Water Cliffs. Murder. Two copies of Murder. Lazotep Reaver. Lazotep Reaver. Audacious Thief. Duress. Alright, here are our basic land cards. I'm going to keep them to the side because I want to separate them later. We got Swamp. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. 11 Swamps. I think they all have different art. Very cool. Maybe no, some of them are repeats, but there's different arts for the Swamps. Very cool. Then we got Pattern Masher. Diamond Knight. Paradise Druid. Here are the green cards, my favorite color. Woodland Champion. Overcome. Gravedigger. Chemist's Insight. What is that art? Air Elemental. Warden of Evos Isle. Spectral Sailor. Grand Blue. Brineborn Cutthroat. Bond of Flourishing. Overgrowth Elemental. Clamor Shaman. Ember Hunter. Mask of Immolation. And here come more mana cards. We got Plins. Got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6 Plins. Set these aside. Hopefully it's not only 6 Plins. There's gotta be more. You can't even make a deck with 6 Plins. Scampering Scorcher. Chandra. Novice Pyromancer. Yo, this box comes with Planeswalkers. I actually don't really know how to play with Planeswalkers. I kind of know, but because Steven's box, aka Estebanio's box, the deck builder's toolkit with Shaco on it, didn't have Planeswalkers, but so I'll have to learn how to use Planeswalkers. Apparently, I think you can summon of this mana. Comes with, I think that's the HP, but I don't know how this tapping works. I need to look up how this works. But yeah, she's probably the one on the cover, actually. Is that you, Chandra? They're wearing different things, I think. And Chandra doesn't have the goggles. So maybe not a perfect match. So we got Chandra, Planeswalker. I'm curious if they have Planeswalkers for every color. They must, they should, or else it won't be fair. Plague Crafter. Bleeding Edge. Disfigure. Cry of the Carnarium. Prison Realm. Haz the Marshal. I actually remember this guy from Steven's box. Angel of Vitality. Herald of the Sun. Flying creatures. I hate flying creatures. A Johnny's Pride Mate. Alright, we got some more lands here coming in. We got Forest! 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 forests. So we had 11 swamps, 6 plins, and 11 forests so far. And now let's get into the second one. More dual purpose mana, the Swift Water Cliffs. Let's get this open. Here. Swiftwater Cliffs. Scoured Barrens. Another Scoured Barrens. Blossoming Sands. Another Blossoming Sands. Rugged Highlands. Jaya's Greetings. Grim Initiate. Torch Courier. Infuriate. Soren's Thirst, Bloom Hulk, Thicket Crasher, Return to Nature, Open the Gates, good card, or better known as, The Gates Are Open, Poly Pollen Bright Druid. Gift of Paradise. Really good card. Another Gift of Paradise. Silverback Shaman. Another Silverback Shaman. Leafkin Druid. Leafkin Druid. We got some more lands coming up. Swamp. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 5 swamps. Making our swamp total 16. Now we got Island. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 Islands. Bloodfell Caves. Dismal Backwater. Another Dismal Backwater. Tranquil Cove. Another Tranquil Cove. Chandra's Embercat. Another Chandra's Embercat. Shock. Classic card. I call this guy Echo. But he kind of looks Indian, so I don't know. Let's call him a Chitti. Another Shock. Another Jaya's Greeting. Jaya's Greeting. We got some more lands here. More forest. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 9 forests. I believe we had 6 earlier, so we're at 15. I might be wrong about that. And finally, we got some Moontins. 2 Moontins. Alright. So, we've seen all 5 manas so far. And let's get into the next one. There we go. This guy is my main man. Aggressive Mammoth. I like to call him Manny after the guy in Ice Age. Yeah. So we got Manny here. One of my favorite cards. Probably my favorite card in all of Magic the Gathering. Let's get this pack open. Oh, this one was easier. Wait, was that how I was supposed to open these this whole time? Okay. So we got Manny. Shut up, Chris. Baltimore streets are so confusing. Use your brain, man. Just got a message from Aurori 4. Shivan Dragon, another classic. Grave Walker. Is this a legendary creature? These are the legendary creatures. I think that's what they're called. You can tell they're legendary because of the shiny, No, they're not. No, these are not legendary, my bad. If they're legendary, they'd actually say legendary. These are just rares. If they're rare, you see this shiny thing here. So you got Greywalker, rare card. Riddle Master Sphinx, not a classic. Sarah's Guardian. Alright. Got some lands coming up. Island. 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11 Islands. Bringing our Island total to 16, I believe. Radical Idea. Quench. Dude, so when we were playing in Parker House, I called this card Aunt Jemima. Don't tell me she doesn't look like Aunt. Disdainful Stroke. Impassioned Orator. We got some more lands coming up. Here are the Plins. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. 6 Plins. We got 17 now, I think. Okay, I lose count. Whatever. If you count the numbers, you'll know the actual number. Pacifism. Got 2 of those. Raise the Alarm. Law Rune Enforcer. Oh, finally, we got some mixed cards here. This one's white-green. Iron Root Warlord. Creeping Trailblazer. Trailblazers, more like Failblazers, am I right? yeah. Did you guys know that the first win in the Chase Center for the Golden State Warriors was against the Portland Trailblazers? So the very first team to ever lose there will forever be known as the Golden State Warriors. I mean the Portland Trailblazers. Trailblazers suck. Ogre Siegebreaker. Homebound Lich, Empyrean Eagle, Scuttlemutt, and got some more lands. Got Moontin. 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11. Yeah, so we got 13 Moontins now. And yeah, we got one more pack to go. Looking to see some more either Planeswalkers or legendary creatures. So far we only had the one Planeswalker. If we only have one I might actually take her out. I forgot her name already, but if only one, what's it? One color has the Planeswalker, everyone would go for it, right? Or maybe not, I don't know. Maybe I should keep it in. We'll see. It will be fun. So far, only red has a Planeswalker. Oh my goodness. So, the easy way to open it on the last one, this one doesn't have it. So I'm back to struggling. I'm on borrowed time too, because my phone's gonna run out of battery. Worst case, I'll stop what I'm doing when my phone dies, and I'll resume once I charge it. Oh my god, why are these? I'm so bad at opening these. Alright, last one before we get into the packs.
Thornwood Falls, two of those. Rugged Highlands, Bloodfell Caves, Goblin Crater Maker, Grim Initiate, Unsummon, stupid. Another Unsummon, Frost Lynx, Callous Dismissal, Negate, Vorsclaw, Soren's Thirst. Shout out to Daniel, aka Onbars. I think the guy's name's, your favorite character's name, Soren, right? Obnixilus Cruelty, Spark Harvest. This is Planeswalker support. Or whatever. Anti. Lazeltep Reaver. Aerial Assault. Defiant Strike. Disenchant. Healer's Hawk. Classic card. I love running this guy in nerd drafts. Hunted Witness. Gateway Plaza. We got some more lands coming up. We got Island. 1, 2, 3 Islands. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. 8 Plins. Deadweight. Cloudkin Seer. Winged Words. Evolving Winds. Risen Reef. Sky Knight Vanguard. Shout out to Vanguard. Molder Vine Reclamation. Lightning Stormkin. Corpse Knight. Got some more lands here. Moonton. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7 Moontons. And we got some Swamps. I'm disappointed. Doesn't look like there's any more Planeswalkers. Swamp. 1, 2, 3, 4. 4 Swamps. Alright, so that's it for the packs. Or no, for the non-packs. Let's set these up over here. And now, hang on, I'll move these aside. I should have been doing this on the mat. What the hell am I doing? Alright, here are the packs. About 4 packs here. Guilds of Ravnica, Ravnica Allegiance, War of the Spark, and Corset 2020. I guess we'll go left to right. Let's lay these out for aesthetic. For the aesthetic. The 5 lands. I'm running out of space. Let's open Guilds of Ravnica. Okay, what are the chances that we get 4 more Planeswalkers, one of each a color that we have are missing? All right. Rubble Belt Boar. Call of the Culprit. Urban Utopia. Shout out to Utopia from, what's it called? Yu-Gi-Oh! Mudmark Painter. Sumala Woodshaper. Hypophysizzle. Prey Upon, classic card. Gravitic Punch. Dimir Locket, classic. The Lockets are classics. Centaur Peacemaker. What is this? Is this a token? Wait, what the heck is this? I don't know how to use this card. Is this like a double card? Okay. It's Flower and Flourish. Silent Dart. Crawl Swarm.
another one of these. How do you use these? Is it just one card, but you can use both? You can use one or the other? In that case, what's the point? Why not just make two cards? Boros Guildgate. And we got a soldier. Alright. That's the first pack. Kind of disappointing. I don't think we got any rares. Just looking at the bottom, right? The bottom will tell you. This one's a rare. What the heck? The dual purpose? The weird double card is a rare? I don't know how to use those. I don't know if I don't even know if I'll even use them.
Ravnica Allegiance next.
Scorchmark. Haas the officer. Persistent petitioners. Sorrow form hybrid. Undercry scavenger. Catacomb crocodile. Chillbringer, aka Blue Man Group. Rubble reading. Blade juggler, another classic. Gate colossus. Mockery. Sentinel's Mark. Mass Manipulation. What the heck is that mana cost? Wow, this is looks like a really rare card. Don't know what rarity this is, but it's Deface. What the heck? What is creature with defender? Rakdos Guildgate. And we got an illusion token. These tokens. Like, what if... Did it just give out random tokens in packs? Or did they synergize with the cards that come in it? War of the Spark next. No Planeswalkers. We got that really shiny card. I don't know what rarity that is, but that's probably our best pull so far. Goblin Assailant. Makeshift Battalion. Kazmina's Transmutation. Primordial Worm. Lazotep Behemoth. Trusted Pegasus. Arlen's Wolf. Callous Dismissal. Nahiri's Stormblades. Cyclops Electromancer. Flux Channeler. Dead Horde Twins. And oh, we got a Planeswalker, guys. And it's a legendary. Karn. He's element, it looks like. You can read him. Pause the video if you want to read him here. He looks like he's a pretty good card. He's a rare right here. Nice pull. Whoa, another really shiny card. We got a basic swamp. But Saheeli Silverwing, another manaless card. That's a really funny effect. Can't wait to put him in the draft. Swamp, we got a swamp. Zombie army. So, I don't know what to do with these tokens, but... hopefully we'll use them. If not, they'll just be randomly be there. And finally, the Corset 2020 booster pack. As of the filming of this video, it's not even 2020 yet. So exciting to see what's in here. I wonder if they're like NBA and do their things in advance. You know, like how it's NBA 2K20 or 2K, yeah, right now. Okay, this is a special pack, or am I just? Oh, I'm just looking at the back. Alright guys, final pack. Undead Servant. Aerial Assault. Squad Captain. Fathom Fleet Cutthroat. Pacifism. I've seen a lot of these cards already because it looks like it's the same thing as like what's in the toolkit. Growth Cycle. Pack Mastiff. Negate. Agonizing Siphon. Sage's Row Denizen. Yo, another Blue Man Group right here. Vengeful Warchief. Eternal Isolation. Yo, who's that? Lightning Stormkin. We got a rare card right here. Cavalier of Gales. We got another Swamp. A lot of Swamp mana. And Golem Token. All right. And that's it. That's the box, guys. Thank you for watching through this video. Oh, I left some mountains here.
But yeah, this is everything you get from one of these deck builders toolkits.
Screw this tripod.
This is everything you get from a deck builder's toolkit. The one I got right here is the 2020 one. And yeah, it's a lot of cards. You get tons of mana. You get a decent amount of cards from booster packs. There's a chance for pulling some rare ones. And then you get, like, look at this, a ton of cards to play with, to build decks with, and to draft with. So it looks like it's going to be a lot of fun. Recommend this if you ever want to draft with your friends. I had a lot of fun with my roommates back at the Parker house, and I feel like I'll have a lot of fun with my friends here in San Jose. See you guys at Legends. It's your main man Wing Drops, and we're done.
Hi, I'm very sorry, but this guy who made the video sucks.
It's a solid 6 out of 10. Yo, Annie, basically.
Subscribe, like the video.
Yes, my
share
friends.
It's time to...
That's the good one.
Mamma mia.
Mamma mia.
Bide your time and hold out hope.